Just about to hear push workout, pro dog commentary, so hope you all enjoy it. Let's go.
Alright guys, welcome. So, sorry about my voice, I'm just today, I come off a bit of a sore throat, so I'm hoping tomorrow's not much better, hoping tomorrow's not worse, because it's just day one, so I was actually holding off on making this video until I bought a microphone, but I didn't finish working until bloody like 6 o'clock today, so just going to use my camera again. So just starting off with incline dumbbell press. So just getting a full stretch all the way down, making sure the dumbbells hit my chest, and then really focusing on just squeezing the chest, thinking about contracting your chest with your brain, not just doing the movement, actually thinking about using your chest to lift the weight. That's my main thing. As you might have saw, before I go down, I always roll my shoulders up, back, and then down. And that, in doing that, rather retracts your scapula and puts you in a good position to press. Putting the belt on. So lately I do push workouts, push, pull, and legs. And lately I've been doing, on the push days, I've been doing sort of a chest movement, then I'll jump over to the shoulder, and then chest, shoulder. So that's what I did in this workout today. So first shoulder movement was the standing military press. So making sure to keep the bar traveling in a straight direction upwards and just moving your head out of the way for the bar. So everything's staying straight except for your head just coming out. Spine's nice and straight. And just getting a good hold and squeeze at the top and coming all the way down. It's the most important part. It's really trying to focus on the muscle you're hitting. Next up, another shoulder movement. So doing a side lateral raise, but doing a bit of a superset or just sort of big set. So starting off just really lightweight. I think it was 15 pounds. So like 7-ish, 6 kilos, up to 20 and then 25 pounds. So about half the pounds is kilos. So start in the middle, go up one step. So 15, 20, and then 25 on the third step, and then back down. So doing about 10 reps on each weight, and it's an absolute killer. As you can see, it really starts burning towards the end. So once again, just really focusing on getting that mind muscle connection right, making sure I'm pulling with my elbows, so my elbows are coming up to the air first before the dumbbells aren't above my elbows. So elbows up first and making sure that it's your shoulder working and not your back and chest. So really starting to burn now. I'm a bit of a believer in force reps towards the end of, like, if you're gonna get a good solid 8 to 10 reps at a weight, and they're all like really nice controlled slow reps, and if you think you can get some more, I'd like to swing and make sure. So I might swing on the up, but I'm always making sure that you're trying to hold the eccentric part. You're trying to just hold as much as you can, just tear those fibers. So this is a highly recommended set. This is, I feel like it's been, I do this and a lot of military press, and I feel like that's brought up my shoulders quite a lot. Just in the recent, last year, I feel like my shoulders have grown a lot more. Sort of neglected them when I first started, sort of like didn't really think about it. So just as you just saw there, that was my shoulder going up, back and down. And now we're just doing So dumbbells together, holding them together, the whole movement, and just a close incline press again, but just working more of the inner chest with this one. So I'm pretty happy with my lower chest. I sort of just want to bring up my upper chest. So this is more of an upper chest workout and shoulders. So this one, as I'm going up, I'm sort of going up and then going back over towards my head, as you'll just see on this angle now. So I'm going up, down, holding dumbbells on a weight on an angle, and then going up and back over my head, and just really focusing on that mind muscle connection with the chest. And you can really feel it when you go up above your head like that. That's the way I feel it the most. So make sure you give that a go with the superset with a flies on the cable crossovers. So with this, I'm sort of doing a similar sort of movement to that incline press. So I'm coming down and I'm scooping outwards, as you'll just see here. So coming down and then I'm scooping out and holding it. So a good 1 second squeeze and then a slow 2 second eccentric part of the movement, and just really focusing on the mind muscle connection. So by scooping it out, I feel like it just really hits all the chest, and then that, so when you're on the lower part, it's sort of like your lower chest, and then when you bring it out and scoop it like that, it sort of really hits your upper chest and you can feel it. So highly recommend it again. Sorry if my voice is a bit croaky, but yeah, like I said, just woke up, sort of started feeling it last night, and thought I might be getting sick, and then this morning it was just like pretty horrible. So I'm hoping tomorrow's not even worse. So the next commentary will be a better one with the microphone. So just wait for that. And all right. So next up, I've got a front raise just using the cable crossover machine. So I'm just bringing this up nice and slow on the way down, and I'm sort of crossing over my body as well. You sort of can't really see it in this angle, but I'm not just coming straight up, I'm sort of bringing it across my front. You know, I feel like that just hits the front delt a little more, so you'll be able to see it on this other angle. So as you can see, it's bringing it right over, sort of nearly into the line of my other shoulder. And I feel like that just hits that front delt a little more than rather than just coming straight up on the side. So it's about week 2 on the summer shredding competition. I've already down like quite a bit of weight already. I'm sort of down like 3 or 4 kilos. I feel like I'm a fair bit lean already. I'm not feeling the best. I'm sort of feeling a bit flat, but I feel pretty fine. But I've just haven't been getting much sleep lately, but been flat out with work. But body wise, I'm feeling flat, but at the gym I'll get awesome pumps when I'm at the gym, and I'm looking a bit leaner, but when I'm not at the gym, I'm sort of feeling quite flat. But might just got to keep going, I guess. It's all part of it. So makes you feel a bit shit. But so next up, tricep push down. So just using the straight bar on the cables, really focusing on the squeeze here, at least holding for 1 second, squeezing, and then just trying to control it on the way back up. This is a great tricep exercise, and I normally do this superset with the cable, as you'll see. And that's I'm trying to focus. I don't really like training arms like at all, really. They just sort of hurt and like they're pretty boring, but I love the look of them. So I sort of want to bring them up a little bit more. Arms and shoulders, or everything really, chest. But every day I feel a bit different. I'll sort of like really be focusing on, I'll be like, oh damn, my chest is lacking, damn my... The next day it'll be, damn, my shoulders are lacking, and I'll try and base my workouts around that. But at the moment everything's just been feeling a bit off, but... So here we are, just finishing up on the triceps once again, nice and slow, big squeeze at the bottom, controlling the weight on the way back up. Great finisher for the tricep. Few striations coming through, which is cool. Still a long way out, but we'll see how we go. Alright, that is the end, so give it a go, let me know what you think. Alright, here's a little post-workout
physique update. So getting a bit leaner already.